Hello and welcome to your yoga practice today with me, Sarah. Let's get started. Grab your mat and I'll see you there. So find yourself in an upright cross-legged seat for a couple of moments, feeling the length and strength of your whole spine all the way up through the crown of the head, and then rooting down the tailbone toward the earth. Take your hands together in Anjali Mudra, the gesture of thanks. Connect your thumbs to the center of the chest and drop your chin, setting your intention for practice today. What do you want to cultivate in this time on your mat? And let that inspire the effort you put in today. On your inhale, interlace the fingers and press the palms right up and take a sway side to side, feeling the sitting bones root down as we open up through the side waists and tuning into. Smooth inhales through the nose and smooth exhales all the way out through the nose. And as you reach up through the palms, look up. When you exhale, let the arms come down alongside the body and then roll over your knees and come into a tabletop position onto all fours. And then we'll come right up into a downward dog. In this downward dog, take some time to pedal out your feet. Lifting one heel at a time, stretching out the calves, and waking up the backs of the legs. And then we're lifting that right heel high, stretching that right heel straight toward the ceiling. Drop your left heel down to stretch into the calf. Inhale, and when you exhale, slide your right foot through right between the hands. And then we're going to straighten that right leg and turn the right toes in, the right heel out, and come into a wide-legged stance. Come up onto tented fingers on your inhale, lift up, lengthen, and then exhale. Start to fold and let your head go. And we'll do that two more times. Inhale, wave up through the crown, come up onto your fingertips, look forward, and then exhale, fold any amount. And one more time, inhale, wave up, lengthen. Look forward. And then when you exhale, fold and take your hands to your outer ankles and let the crown of head come to the ground. I'm just going to wag the tail a little bit. Nice to open the inner thigh psoas and rooting through the outside edges of the foot, feet. The arches of the feet are lifting. And let's come up onto fingertips and then walk your hands over to the right. Turn your right toes out, bend your right knee very deeply, drop your right sitting bone down. Take your right arm on the inside of the knee, and then open your left arm up into Skandasana. And we're going to inhale, looking at the left hand. Exhale, walk to center, straightening through the legs. And then turn the left toes out, bend deeply, drop down. Left sitting bone toward left heel, right toes point straight up. Left arm on the inside of the knee and stretch the right fingertips up. Looking at the right hand, inhale and exhale. Lift up to center. Come up onto your fingertips. Take your left fingertips in front of your face. Take your right hand on your back. Bend your right knee a little bit. Wrap your right sitting bone toward the left sitting bone as you look to the right. Lengthen from crown to tail. Inhale there. Exhale, look down at your left fingertips. Replace your left fingertips with your right fingertips. And then left hand on your back, look to the left. Turning there. And inhale and exhale, fold. Let your head go. Look at your right foot. Start to walk your hands toward your right foot. Turn your right toes to point straight ahead. Swing that left heel over the toes and step right back to downward dog. Finding the length of the sitting bones. And we'll roll into a light plank. Bring your knees down. On your exhale, come into child's pose, hips to heels. And then stand up on your knees. Roll the shoulder blades down the back. Lightly interlace the fingertips back behind your head. Open your elbows. Lift up through the chest. Inhale. And then exhale, let the arms drape down alongside your body. Draw your belly in. Send your hips toward your heels. and then come into extended child's again. Stretching from the pinkies right to the hips. Now weave into a modified plank. Lower all the way down onto your belly. Come into a Sphinx pose. Elbows are right under the shoulders. Fan the fingers wide. Middle fingers are in alignment with your elbow joint. Drag your palms toward your elbows. Spread your chest. Root through the pelvis. Look up on the inhale. Exhale. Slowly melt. Stack one palm on top of the other.
Come into a crocodile pose. Rest your forehead right on tops of your hands. Separate your toes a little bit. Wag your tail side to side. Breathing on the inhale through the nose. Exhale, let it out. Relax your neck and shoulders. Return to your intention for practice. Let the floor support you. And start to press the arms into the ground and peel the head up. Slide your palms back under the elbows. Tuck your toes and come back up to downward dog.
And then we'll stretch that left heel high up into three-legged dog. Let's inhale. Exhale, roll your way into plank. Lifting up the belly. And bring your knees down. Cross your ankles. Sit behind your heels. And start to extend your legs out straight. With your legs extending out straight, flex your feet. Take your hands to your lower back and lift up a little bit, lifting one sitting bone at a time so that we really feel lifted through the lower back right up through the crown of the head. And hug your right heel toward the sitting bone. The right heel is in alignment with the sitting bone. And then we're going to drag that right sitting bone back and wrap your left arm around that right outer thigh. Take your right fingertips behind you, look to the right for a gentle twist. Resist that outer right thigh into that left forearm. And then open your left hand and touch your left first finger and thumb together so that you make Gayan Mudra, a gesture of concentration. One more inhale. Exhale, let's unwind and cross that right leg over on top of the left. Let the right knee fall forward. And hands are framing the legs, or you can reach for your left toes and breathe there. Lift your left thigh up a little bit so that you don't hyperextend or lock that left knee. The inner thighs are rolling forward and down. And you may be able to gradually fold and bring your nose towards your right knee. One more inhale. Exhale, slowly start to sit up. Lift that right knee up and unwind and extend that right heel out. And then slide your left foot on the ground. We're going to wrap that right arm around, giving that left leg a hug. Nice open right hand. And then right first finger and thumb touch. So you're resisting that forearm into the outer left thigh with a little drag of your right elbow toward the inner arch of your right foot. And resisting that outer left thigh into the forearm as you twist. And we find that space of the belly on the inhale. Exhale, you hollow the belly in toward the spine. One more inhale. Exhale, we're going to unwind and cross that left leg over on top. The left foot is flexed. The right thigh lifts. Sitting here is fine, or you're able to walk forward and maybe catch the right toes. Breathing there. Gradually, as you stay, you could fold forward and bring your nose toward that left knee. It may feel very intense in the back of that right leg from the center of the calf down into the right sitting bone. As you fold, you bring your nose toward that left knee and we'll exhale. And then slowly come on up. Lift that left knee up, unwind, extend. Take a little bounce. Open your toes out. Bring your soles of feet together. Knees splay open. Find that bound angle and we'll bring the heels in pretty tight. And open your feet like the pages of the book. And walk your fingertips toward your lower back. Lift up through your side waist. Look up. Maybe you can hover and lift your sitting bones a little bit and then let them come down. Good. So we'll try that again. Lift up. Roll forward a little bit. And then take your hands in front of your toes, interlace your fingers, and open your elbows and gently move your chest forward. Look forward on your inhale, and then exhale. Squeeze in, slide the heels out toward the upper corners of your mat. Reach for your toes there. Spread your chest right between your feet in that variation of Upavista Konasana, where the outer edges of the feet are peeling toward your outer hips. You can look toward your tail. And then round the spine, flex your feet, push your hands into your feet, and then drop your tail, look toward your belly. And we're gonna start to sit up. As we sit up, lift your knees, bring your feet together, and then bring your palms into prayer. Point your prayer hands toward your tailbone, hug your inner elbows in and up. Really challenging on the core. Flex your feet. And we're going to inhale there. And we're going to exhale. Release. Fingertips forward. Thumbs up. Let's come down onto the back. Make your way all the way onto the back and hug your knees in towards your body. Zip your knees together. Cross your left ankle on top of the right. Lift your heels a little bit, open your arms out to a cactus, and then let the knees go over to the right and look to your left, and then bring the knees back in using your lower belly. Let the knees drape to the left and look to the right, and pull them back in and to the right, almost all the way, and then back in and to the left, and then back in and all the way to the right. And if it feels okay on your body, you could kick the legs out straight and try to catch the feet in that right hand. Take the left arm out to a T and look to the left. Breathing to draw that left thigh away from your chin. And we'll inhale. And we'll exhale, hug the belly in. Good. And then look toward your knees. Draw your knees back in. Bring your feet on the ground to recenter. Nice long line from back of head to tail. Now pull your knees in, cross your right ankle on top, and bring the knees over to the left. And you can always kick your feet out and catch your feet in your left hand and pull that right sitting bone away from the chin and spill your gaze out to the right if that's okay on your neck, or just keep your gaze neutral at the ceiling. Tune into the spaces that could use some space. The light of the inhale filling into any tension. And then the exhale empties you out, belly hugging in toward the spine for a moment of pause at the end of the exhale. And then looking toward your knees, gently draw your knees back into center. Recenter to lay that sacrum in alignment with the base of the skull. Hug your knees in with hands on one knee. So the warmth of one hand on each knee. Then start to circulate and make some swirling circles. Massaging out your back. You can go one direction and then the other. Good. And then when your feet come down onto the ground, give your feet a nice press. Root through the feet. Make a gentle fist in both hands. Lift up your hips just enough to squeeze the gluteals and reset your back. And then lay your lower back onto the ground and extend your legs out for a Shavasana meditation. Close your eyes. Take an inhale through your nose. Exhale, let it out. And let your head roll. Unwinding your neck, let your shoulders and upper body dissolve. And all that softness flows through all the joints, down into the calves, down into your heels and toes, And your whole body is awake and aware and alive and vibrant with your own prana, the life force that flows through you. Imagining a lot of warmth accumulating in the center of the palms, your own healing awareness. Bring your hands onto your belly, offering your own healing energy to your body and inviting compassion for exactly where you're at today. Can you remember your intention, celebrating that intention, and finding a little bit of gratitude for this breath, for this moment? Anything you have to be grateful for, inviting it in. I'm starting to wiggle your toes and stretch your arms overhead. Take a reset, like you're hitting the restart button. All the systems resetting. And gently hug the knees in. Take your time to roll to either side, pausing for a moment, and then slowly pressing up to sit. Arriving up again in an upright cross-legged seat, sitting really tall. Let's stretch the fingertips away on the inhale, slowly reaching up. Palms press, look up. Exhale, bring the hands down right through the central channel. And we're connecting the thumbs to the center of the chest. Let's honor each other and this practice by dropping the chin toward your chest. And I am wishing you joy, peace, health, strength, courage, and trust on the journey. Namaste. So grateful for your presence here in my yoga community. Drop me a comment. Let me know if you liked this video. And please also hit that super thanks button to support my channel. And I appreciate you spreading the word. And I really hope you feel better. Have a great day. See you next time.